Hi everybody, I'm Naufal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss regarding theoretical and conceptual framework. Most of the students are confused with these terms, theoretical and conceptual framework. For beginners, they don't know what is conceptual framework and what is theoretical framework, whether these two terms are same or is there any difference between conceptual and theoretical framework. Definitely, there is a difference between conceptual and theoretical framework. Let's start with a simple example for your better understanding. Okay, so suppose you want to cook and you are planning to cook vegetable soup. So from where you will get the recipe? You are searching for the recipe. Finally, you are getting the recipe of your mother. From the mother, you got a recipe how to cook vegetable soup. Now, according to the recipe of your mother, you started to cook vegetable soup. You taken the vegetables, you added the salt, you added the chili powder according to the recipe of your mother. You are following the recipe of your mother. Okay, finally you prepared a vegetable soup. From where you got the recipe? From your mother. This is called theoretical framework. Now you will get confused. How? Just take the example, the vegetable soup as the research problem, as your research problem, and recipe of your mother as an theory. You are using the recipe of your mother, that is, you are using the theory of someone else, and the topic is your one. The research problem is vegetable soup, it is your one, and the recipe of the vegetable soup, that is your mother's one. It is not your one, it is someone else's recipe. So, in theoretical framework, you are using the theory of someone else for your research study. You can define theoretical framework as, it is the explanation of the relationship between the theory, the existing theory, and your research study. That is the vegetable soup and the recipe of your mother. The theory is not your one. You are using an existing theory. That recipe is already existed, right? You are using your mother's recipe, but study is your one. Okay? So, for example, your research topic is adaptation of patient with chronic pain. Okay? Adaptation of patient with chronic pain. So, you are using the theory of adaptation. That theory is not your one, but the topic is your one. Adaptation of patient with chronic pain. You are using the theory of others' theory only. It is not your one. It is an existing theory. And you are trying to make a relationship with your topic with the existing theory. You are using an existing theory to construct a theoretical framework. Got it? You made a vegetable soup using the recipe of your mother. Recipe is not your one. Like that in research, you made a theoretical framework by using others' theory. Theory is not your one, but the research study, concept of the research study is your one. And you are trying to explain the relationship between the concept of the research study with the existing theory. Okay. Now, what is meant by conceptual framework? With the same example regarding the mother's recipe and the vegetable soup. Now, you are planning to alter, or you want to make that soup more delicious and more tasty. So you are adding, according to your idea, you are adding 3 or 4 components. That is pepper, chili sauce or tomato sauce, whatever you required. You are adding that things according to your idea. Okay, now the recipe is changed. Now it is not your mother's recipe. Now it is the recipe of your one only. You added something from the outside. In that recipe, these things are not there, but 3 or 4 components you added. From where? According to your concept. Concept means idea. According to your idea, you added the things. Now come to the topic. If it is a theory, means according to your idea, you are adding 2-3 things. Okay, so you developed that recipe, or you developed that theory. That is conceptual framework. Conceptual framework means It is the explanation of the relationship between the logically constructed concept. That is, logically constructed ideas. Your idea, you added pepper, you added tomato sauce, you added chili sauce, that were not in the recipe of your mother. Right? So, your logically constructed concept and your concept of research study. It is the explanation of the relationship between your logically constructed concept with the concept of your research study. Okay. So, in conceptual framework, you are using your ideas. You are constructing your ideas. You are adding your ideas to that theories according to your ideas. But in theoretical framework, you are using an existing theory. You are not adding anything. You are using an existing theory to construct a theoretical framework. Okay. So, what is the difference between theoretical and conceptual framework? Okay. Let's see. In theoretical framework, an existing theory is used. Already a theory is existing. You are using that theory for your research topic. Okay. In conceptual framework, you are developing a theory or you are developing your ideas. You are using your ideas in conceptual framework. Okay. Next one, in theoretical framework, mainly testing of theories occurred. Testing of the theories occurred. But in conceptual framework, development of the theory is occurred. And regarding theoretical framework, you can use widely. For most of the research problem, you can use theoretical framework because theories are available for you. But in conceptual framework, some specific research problem can use conceptual framework. Not for all the research problem you can use conceptual framework. Okay. And from where you will get the theoretical as well as conceptual framework. You will get the theory from literature review only. After finding the research problem, you will try to find out the knowledge related to your research problem. So, you will get the theories related to your topic. Okay. Suppose your research topic is performance of nurses after motivation. So, for theoretical framework, you are taking the theories of motivation. Okay. You are taking the theory of motivation and you are explaining and you are making a relationship with the performance of nurses after motivation with the theory of motivation. That is theoretical framework. With the same example, regarding the conceptual framework, in the theories of motivation or some other theories, you are adding your ideas. Motivation may differ according to the age. Motivation may differ according to the sex. Motivation may differ according to the educational status. Okay, according to your idea, you are adding something. You are constructing your concept. In theoretical framework, you are using an existing theory and you are establishing a relationship with that theory. Got it? That's all regarding theoretical and conceptual framework. I hope you have understood the topic. We will meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.